Saturday's Women's March was the biggest one-day protest in the United States. An estimated 2.9 million people took to the streets to defy the new administration and President Donald Trump's alleged disregard for the rights of women and other marginalized groups.
Well, I just think it's, you know, important for us to stand up for things that we believe. Most importantly, women's rights. For me, I believe that the women's rights are human rights.
I felt embarrassed as a woman. They certainly do not represent me. I came here to see my new president in his inauguration. I felt like they aren't clear on what and why they are protesting.
The numbers of marches were staggering. Officials estimate between 250,000 to a million in the main march in Washington, D.C., between 200,000 to 750,000 in Los Angeles, between 200,000 to 500,000 in New York. And these figures do not even include more than 600 other sister marches all over the U.S. and in other parts of the world. On Sunday, President Trump took to Twitter to downplay the historic event. He tweeted, "I watched the protests yesterday but was under the impression that we just had an election. Why didn't these people vote? Celebs hurt cause badly." Celebrities like Madonna, Scarlett Johansson, and America Ferrera took part in the massive movement. The global protests, although loud, were relatively done in a peaceful manner. And the president once again took to the microblogging site to react. He said, "Peaceful protests are a hallmark of our democracy. Even if I don't always agree, I recognize the rights of people to express their views." Compared to his predecessor, Barack Obama, who enjoyed a 79% approval rating from polls coming into his term, recent polls conducted by Quinnipiac University, ABC Washington Post, Monmouth University, and CNN ORC found that only between 34% and 40% of people have a positive opinion of President Trump. Some political pundits say President Trump has a tough road ahead because he enters the White House without the benefit of a united country behind him. And they say the only way to increase public confidence in him is to immediately get major, sensible policies done, from creating new jobs to keeping Americans safe.
Kenny Espinosa, ABS-CBN News, Washington, D.C.